the law. So we have to wear masks because nobody can breathe around. The air cannot circulate because the germs could get into her tubing. And exactly. And she would die. So she's going to be showing you guys what she's doing to hook up to her machine.
So I'm going to clean my exit site first. And my exit site is this area right here that connects to my catheter, that connects to his tubing, that the fluid goes into and then comes out, and it goes into this clear bag right here at the end of the night. Well, after 6 hours, it takes an hour 12 each thing, and it gives me four different fills, and then it drains. I mean, then it sits for an hour each time, and then it comes out. So okay, and then I have to.
And did you want to tell them about your channel?
Oh, I have a YouTube channel. It's Cynthia Star. Cynthia is CYNTHIA. Star is STARR. Capital C and capital S. The rest is lowercase. And it'll be me in the picture with my hair in a bun. And my hair's pink. In the picture. So I'm going to take this Exact, and this is Skin Exit Site Wound Cleaner. And I'm going to take this 4x4.
And this video is for people 21 and older. It's not suitable for children under 21, at least supervised by their adult parents, and they are their own responsibility, not ours. And it's not also YouTube's responsibility. It's their parents' responsibility. So this video is for 21 and older. Well, it's really adult because you're showing your stomach.
So this is my exit site. It's still healing. I'm diabetic. So what my nurse Allison told me, is that it's gonna take longer for me to heal. So it does look a little red and irritated, but trust me, it's not. It's just my skin getting used to a foreign object in my body. This tube actually connects to a small catheter that has like a fuzzy part on the top under here. That's why it's like poking out.
It's like a filter.
Yeah, it's like a filter, and then it connects to a smaller tube that goes into my peritoneal cavity, and that's what keeps the fluids in there, and it expands it, and it dwells in there. I already sanitized my hands. You're supposed to sanitize every time you want to start this process. You sanitize. You have to be very aseptic with all of this stuff because you can catch an infection very quickly and very easily.
Spending the night with my grandson. My grandson is in bed already.
I used to do that, but because it's already healed, almost pretty much, I only put it like that. And I take smaller gauze that's cut a certain way.
articles on my daughter's channel, and you guys could ask her questions, and she will answer your emails.
I'll answer all questions, all emails. I'll talk about my medical journey. I'll talk about my my recovery with my addiction. I'll talk about my past experiences as a nighttime entertainer.
Socrates and Mastiff, no?
No, I'll use this for this part. Just to take I have a lot of stories, and I'm also getting on into actually conspiracy theories. So I have a video up right now that's talking about the Kanika Jenkins story. I do believe she died, but I believe that they were also doing something else in that hotel. So
did you guys talk about paranormal?
Yeah, I talk about that. I talk about a lot of spiritual stuff. I talk about having experience with paranormal situations. I've had an experience where I've actually died and come back.
Yeah, my daughter was in coma for
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
And I went into coma again. Alrighty, so that part's done. And now I'm going to connect my two fluid bags to the lines. This should be in here. This is how I know.
Now the machine is of the fluid on the top.
Yeah, this is the heater pad. This is my dialysis machine. This is the heater pad. It warms up the bag. And then I get two bags. This is the tubing, and this is the bag that it goes into underneath. Now I'm gonna connect. I have like the mini caps and stuff, so that if I need to go to the bathroom at night, because I do still produce urine, so I do use the bathroom. I think these did completely fail, but I do produce about 2 liters.
Pee, what happens? You become a what? Twice your size, right?
Yeah, I'm not able to pee. I end up swelling up really bad. Like, I swell up to 50 pounds more. So, let me
cautious.
This is Cynthia in the background. If anyone is looking, or I mean interested in becoming a donor, please feel free to message me. I'm looking for A negative and O negative or O positive blood types.
It's crazy because now
she passed out.
I passed out the last time here. I thought it was my sugar, but it wasn't my sugar. It was my blood pressure. And it was crazy. Because, like, all of a sudden, I remember falling on the floor and my feet sinking up. And I was like, what the hell? So, that was crazy.
Are you going to be doing makeup in your channel, too?
Yeah, I'm going to be doing makeup. Okay, so now it says, connect clamps and, open the clamps and connect the bags. I already connected the bags. So now, I'm going to open. These are called clamps right here. Half an inch or an inch of air, because to my knowledge, it's gonna really hurt when it goes in you. They tell you that it's gonna be an experience you're never gonna want to experience again. So you press go, and I was gonna say, I think this part takes a little bit.
So, what else do you want to be doing in your what did they say about how long people be at dialysis before they get a donor?
It all varies. Like, I know there's a girl that's doing the same exact dialysis as me, and she's been on it for 9 years. She's kind of worried because they say usually they'd rather people not be on dialysis for longer than 9 to 10 years.
Yeah.
But she was on chemo, and then she went to peritoneal. So right now she's looking for a donor. But me, I have somebody in mind who wants to be a donor, but we're not sure. Because I just found out, I don't know if I can accept from being positive, from O positive or O negative, because I was on the chart and said A negative, and O was O negative, but he's O positive, so I don't even know if that's going to work out now. So, I have an appointment on the 13th for him to get the information and him to get the stuff to get tested, but, what's today, 6th or 7th?
I would have said it's 7th. Yeah, prayer, support. Right now, she don't have any friends. I'm her friend because all her friends are on the wrong path, and she don't want that anymore. I don't know what she gets. She got a very
right there.
See the liquid?
Now it's up here. Yep, it's primed. It's gonna beep in a minute, and then I have to scrub my set, and then
yep. My only daughter. How old are you, Cindy, again? I don't even know how old is my own daughter. Just kidding, guys. 29 and her brother's 27. Look at him right there. That's Cindy and Hayden. And he's just a little baby. All right.
He's at this off steroid.
same stuff. Gotta bleach my clothes.
Is this priming?
Priming, yeah. It's gonna say that for like a couple more seconds.
It's priming. I guess the medication and machine.
With this machine, I can travel. I can send it. I can send it through the airport, send it off, and then have my fluids delivered to wherever I'm gonna be at. Or I could do like I did and go somewhere and travel with it.
Carry on.
Yep, it comes in a big suitcase. Oh. It's over there. It comes in a big black suitcase. I would rather have done peritoneal dialysis than hemo, honestly, because hemo takes a lot out of you. You can only drink a certain amount of ounces, eat a certain amount, 32 ounces. That's, yeah. Now that I'm dealing with kidney failure, I drink a lot more. Like, it's crazy. At least I drink a lot more fluids.
I know. She never used to drink water. She hated water. Now?
I hated it. Yeah, now I drink nothing but diet ginger ale. My phosphorus from drinking diet Pepsi was a 7. And then I went to an appointment. I was disconnected.
So you gotta.
My phosphorus was a 7, yourself. And
certain
then it went
patient
from
line connecting yourself.
It went from a 7 to a 4 from not drinking diet Pepsi. So
you're supposed to drink soda anyway. It's not good for your bones.
And I'm still kind of going through caffeine withdrawals, but it's alright. Alright, so now we try this off. This is twist to open, press go, it'll say verify initial drain, eye drain off, because I go to bed and I don't go to bed with anything in my stomach. It drains it before I go, like before it finishes, but it's still, look at, put it here, but it's still gonna drain a little bit that I do have in my stomach. It's an automatic response with the machine.
Ooh.
You see it?
Warning.
Yep, that's the iodine in the cap. That's disinfectant. That's the iodine. That doesn't do anything.
Warning. Not a cute sight. So you have a weak stomach, turn your head.
So yeah.
That's, we said it all late.
No, that's just iodine. That's not. That's just dye. The dye that's
I know.
In the cap. So.
But it smells like iodine.
That's it. And I'm connected.
And should be there into
tomorrow,
the bag. And the bag is finished. And the
it's
bag
full.
Is full.
Yep.
Well, guys, this is Debbie. Let me see over there. This is Debbie saying goodbye.
And
this is
Star.
Cynthia.
And Cynthia Star is STARR, capital C and capital S.
All right, guys. Into the next one.